Beth Finegan is with us, the Indiana County Humane Society, as we close out this month of May, which has been eventful enough, and get ready for a month of June, which is going to be quite eventful for the Humane Society.
Oh, we do have an exciting month coming up and are looking forward to it. One of the most important things we're doing for the community this month is having a microchipping clinic.
Mm-hmm.
And as you can well imagine, with the weather we've been having, there have been lots of dogs that are scared and afraid, and they might run away from their homes.
Yeah.
And so we've seen an uptick in calls about dogs that are lost. Mm-hmm. Or dogs that are found that people don't know who the owners are. So one of the very first things that we do when we have a stray dog turned into the shelter is we scan them for a microchip.
Uh-huh.
And that if a dog is microchipped, it provides us with the owner's name and contact information, and then we can more easily reunite the dog with its owner.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're doing for the community is on June 15th at the shelter from 1 to 3 p.m., we are having a microchipping clinic. No reservations necessary. You can just show up with your dog. The cost is $15, and this will make it so in the unfortunate event, if your dog does get lost, we can easily identify that you're the owner of it.
Yeah, dog has to have a license.
And the dog also needs to have an Indiana County license,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah. But a part of that as well is we're thinking about storms and thunder, but here comes the 4th of July and fireworks. And so you might as well get it done now, June 15th. That way all the information is ready to go if the dog gets frightened from fireworks and runs off.
Oh, good point, Todd. Yeah, loud noises, unexpected events, that's what scares dogs and many other animals. And so, yeah, this is a good time to get this taken care of. It's low cost, $15, again, at the shelter on June 15th from 1 to 3 p.m. Mm-hmm. in the afternoon.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk a little bit about cats. This is really exciting news, this grant that you got. You got a ton of kitty litter.
Yeah, we did.
Well, you got more than a ton.
Well, true that. Yeah, our grant team reached out to World's Best Cat Litter, and we were chosen to partner with them in their 2019 Give Litter promotion.
Mm-hmm.
Literally this week, and I happened to be at the shelter when the truck pulled in, we received 5,000 pounds of cat litter to use at the shelter with our cat population. They're also providing us with promotion materials. June is, as I'm sure you know, Adopt a Shelter Cat Month.
Mm-hmm.
And so what we'll do at the shelter is all during the month of June have half-price cat adoptions. For the first 20 people that adopt cats, World's Best Cat Litter has given us giveaway bags that have coupons and various materials in them.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll also be promoting this at our various events around the community during the month of June. So
yeah,
it's really exciting. And I'm sure you remember, we also had another cat adoption grant given to us by the Pet Founder Foundation.
Yeah, I remember.
And we've just completed using those monies, and we were able to adopt out 36 cats at no charge because of this grant.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah,
wonderful.
It is.
So you've got 2.5 tons, actually, of World's Best Cat Litter that have been given to you. That particular grant that you were just talking about, which makes people say, oh, 36 cats got adopted. There must not be any left at the shelter.
Oh, my. Well, that's not the case. We have about 120 cats and kittens that are available for adoption right now at the shelter. We are excited when we get these kind of grants. It helps us to promote cat adoption. And again, June is Adopt a Shelter Cat Month. So we're going to be hoping to adopt a lot of those cats and kittens out.
And at the same time, you encourage people to get them spayed and neutered and there are, you know, there's always something going on that allows people to go out and get that done.
And, oh, most definitely. Yeah. And, you know, we have an initiative at the shelter going on where we want to have all our cats and dogs spayed or neutered mm-hmm. before they're on the floor for adoption. Uh-huh. And that's a big undertaking. But we're getting there. And in fact, this weekend, the fixin' wagon is going to be in town, and six more of our cats are going to get spayed and neutered through at the fixin' wagon this weekend. So we're getting towards our goal of having our entire shelter population being fixed.
Love the fixin' wagon.
I know.
Hey, the fixin' wagon's coming, and all the cats go, "What?" No. A part of what the Humane Society must do, it is imperative, is that you raise funds, and you've got some fundraisers coming up in June.
Yeah, we sure do. During the course of the year, our volunteers put on fundraisers, and then also local community organizations and companies offer to put on fundraisers for us. Mm-hmm. And June is a great example of different organizations and companies in our wonderful community reaching out and partnering with the shelter to do some fundraising. So we have got quite a slate coming up. We will be having our Yappy Hours starting up at Benjamin's, and those go on the second Thursday of every summer month. So the first one is going to be on June 13th. Thank you. From 5 to 7 p.m., this is at Benjamin's. For a $10 donation at the door, you get to come in and enjoy on their patio drink specials, their special appetizers available. There's music. We have door prizes. It certainly is a dog-friendly event, and we get a fantastic group of people and their dogs, and we have a really good time with it.
Bet you get some regulars at that, don't you?
We really do, yeah. And Benjamin's has been so supportive of us over mm-hmm. the years, and this year we're going to do a little twist and make it a Hawaiian theme. Ooh. And so we hope that the community comes out and enjoys a nice little afternoon mm-hmm. In supporting the shelter.
And then, as I'm looking at your schedule, I mean, June 15th is going to be such a big day for you.
Yeah.
Right there in the middle of the month. You've already told us that you're going to be having the microchipping clinic on June 15th. Now you've got a couple of fundraisers that same day.
We sure do. So June 15th, starting at noon, the Moose Lodge on 4th Street is having the annual barbecue. This is really fun. For $8, you get a delicious meal that Chef Mitchell cooks out back. He's barbecuing chicken and pork. The meal includes also sides and a dessert. There's going to be a basket raffle and a chance to win a beautiful quilt. And in honor of Father's Day, because that's Father's Day weekend, the first 50 men who come to the event will get a special gift. And I just want to let everybody know, we will be there until the food sells out, and it sells out pretty quickly. So I suggest getting there at noon or close to that. So we really appreciate the Moose Lodge doing this for us each year and thank their support.
Yeah, that's wonderful. So that begins at noon, right?
That begins at noon, yep. Uh-huh. And then also on June 15th is Levity's Summerfest. And Levity reached out to us wanting to help us do some fundraising. And so what we're doing is we'll have volunteers there from the shelter. This summer, the Levity Brewing Company Summerfest starts with a 5K at 11 o'clock in the morning, and it goes all afternoon with family fun events, a cornhole tournament. There's music all afternoon and into the night, and volunteers from the Humane Society will be walking around collecting $10 donations, and for every $10 donation, you receive a special hand-designed wooden nickel that you can then turn in for a free pint of beer.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's a wonderful thing. One of these things is you've got all of this activity happening on that day. You're going to need a lot of people, aren't you?
Yeah.
You've got some nice volunteer staff.
Oh, we have tremendous volunteers, and I'm just being involved with the Humane Society now for these past few years, I'm just amazed at the people who are willing to come out, give their time, have some fun, and work to make it so we can keep our shelter doors open. That's really the bottom line. Yeah. So we are lucky to have the wonderful group that we do have, and we're always looking for more volunteers to help us at events. Of course, we have our weekly bingo games at the Elks every Sunday. We certainly would love to have people help us out at those games, and all they have to do is just call the shelter, and then we can connect with them and get them involved.
Yeah, and if somebody wants to actually help at the shelter with some of their operations, they can volunteer for that too?
Yep. At the shelter, we have people who do dog walking, socializing with cats, helping us keep the shelter clean. So, yes, most certainly, you can if that's more in your wheelhouse to be at the shelter and work with the animals, you can certainly do that as well.
All right. So being a very much a not cat person, socializing with cats, you ignore it and it ignores you? Well, there's probably a little bit more to it than that, isn't
there? We need to get you to the shelter, Todd, and put you in the cat colony hours.
That will never, ever happen. Oh, gracious. I just got an involuntary shiver when you said that.
Can I mention one more thing that's happening in June?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
This just kind of came together yesterday. Our local Domino's is now under new ownership, and they are going to do a Domino's for the Shelter Dogs and Cats event on on June 26th. It's a Wednesday, and a portion of their sales from that day, all day long, is going to be donated back to the Humane Society. So we're looking forward to creating Wednesday, June 26th.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, terrific.
I know. It's going to be a busy and fun June.
Good on them. My goodness gracious, you got a busy, busy time coming up.
Uh-huh.
All right, get your sleep, take your milk bath.
Okay.
And you're ready to go.
That's right.
She's Beth Finegan. If somebody wants to learn about the Indiana County Humane Society, Facebook page, yes?
Yes, Facebook page. Our website is incohumanesociety.com. Mm-hmm. It has all our contact information on it, as well as the listing of these events coming up.
That's wonderful. Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Thank you, Beth.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Todd.
It is the voice of Indiana County, WCCS, AM 1160 and 101.1 FM. Fox News is on the way next.